Hadi Mirza, Jasmine Tai, Jonathan Leung. You put them on this stage, but who will you send to the grand finals at the Singapore Indoor Stadium? Someone will be going home tonight. This is Singapore Idol. Directed by Tom Hanks, here are your idols with The Wonders, That Thing You Do. Thank you very much. Give it up one more time. Come on. Show some love. Let me take this away. We've got Jonathan. We've got Jasmine. And we've got Hadi. Okay, guys, lady, take a seat. And we'll be with you in a while. Okay, here we go. Okay. Welcome to Singapore Idol. We are live on the result show. This is it. This is the night. We've come down to this after 15 weeks of voting. Tonight, you will decide who is the top two finalists. Remember, the lines are still open, so you can still make a difference. You can still vote as many times as you like. You vote, you decide. Remember, you're voting for your Singapore Idol. First now, let's say hello to our Singapore Idol judges. Give it up for Dick Lee. Florence. Jacinda and Ken Lim. Okay, question for you. How do you think, what do you think about the performances last night?
Hadi has lived up to expectations.
Okay.
He was especially good in Got to Get You Into My Life. I like that.
Okay.
For Jonathan, I think that he has endorsed the potential to be actually commercially very viable.
Okay, good for him.
Jasmine wasn't one of her better days, yeah, but she remained very sweet.
That's nice, that's nice. Now, grand finals coming up in a very short while. How do you think Singapore should vote? No, I didn't say who they should vote. I asked how should they vote. That's a difference.
You know, Ken? Okay, okay,
hang on.
You know, there are a lot of publications and reports about how these contestants have been doing and different versions of it. You know, at the end of the day, you should just judge basing upon how you feel and not what you read, and not be swayed.
Right.
That is always the right way to go.
Thank you very much, Ken. Okay. Okay, if you missed last night's show, here are the correct voting numbers. Check this out.
Last night, the top three idols sang their favorite songs. Heidi kicked off the show with Got to Get You Into My Life.
And you have a boyish quality which is coming through, which I haven't seen before. You are vocally very reliable.
Then ended with the Eagles classic, Desperado. The sky won't snow and the sun won't shine. It's hard to tell the nighttime from the day.
I would like to see you express the song a little bit more with your physical language.
I think Dick has a point. And do you know what is the solution?
Okay.
Fall in love.
Jasmine sang for her Valentine.
You would still have my heart until the end of time.
You know, you are still in this competition because I think you have made the biggest improvement of any contestant I've ever seen. You know, from nothing you came to be here.
Still on the subject of love, her second song was Some Hearts.
For me, Jasmine, the problem was that you were singing the song, but you didn't own the song. You didn't, you know, grab it by the horns a little bit more than you should have. But I'll give you credit where credit is due. You are the most improved singer on this competition.
Thank you.
Jonathan put his heart and soul into the Phil Collins hit, In the Air Tonight.
Oh, Lord. I've been waiting for this moment for all my life. Oh, Lord.
That was a very intense, a very fantastic interpretation of that song. I think that to be the Singapore Idol, you don't necessarily have to be a fantastic singer, but you need to have some kind of special quality, and I think you've got that.
I think you're a singer with gravitas. And you're able to put some epic splendor into your vocalization, and you do that.
And charm the crowd with his special brand of magic in Every Little Thing She Does Is Magic.
Even though my love before was tragic, now I know my love for her goes on. Every little thing she does is magic. Everything she do just turns me on. Even though my life before was tragic, now I know my love for her goes on.
You know, in your fast numbers, it's just not exciting enough. Yes, it's still cool. It's fast but cool, so it doesn't really go.
It's not about the power, the range or anything else, but the ability to personalize yourself. I think from Unforgettable to Snow Patrol to what you did tonight, you managed to actually do that and do it very well.
Okay, there you go. Remember, the phone lines are still open, but not for long. Every single vote counts. You can still make the difference. Now, here's a special announcement. Listen up. No, the phone lines are still open. No. Mark your calendars. 24th October. October 24th. It's Singapore Indoor Stadium. Fantastic concert. It's called Hype Up Concert. Why? Because it's going to feature some of the top finalists of this season and last season of the show. Season, yes. So mark it down. If you want more details, you have to check the website. It is www.hyperecords.com. I say again, www.hyperecords.com. Got it? Cool. Okay, let's check how the idols are doing, and for that, it's over to Dan.
All right, thanks a lot, Gurmit, and please say hello to your idols once again. Give it up for Hadi Mirza, Jasmine Tai, as well as Jonathan Leong. All right, let's get to some questions right now. And Hadi, now Ken said you need to fall in love in order to understand the song Desperado. Are you going to do that?
I'm not quite sure, but it would be nice to fall in love with that someone who is special. Yeah, it would be nice.
Any takers here?
All right. And Jonathan, now Dick said your fast numbers are not exciting enough. How are you going to improve on that?
I'm going to go back and do a lot more homework. I'm going to watch a lot of videos, a lot of concerts, and see how the professionals do it and make every song exciting.
All right, thank you. Now here's something to take note of. There's going to be a very special studio recording on the 18th of September at 8 p.m. Now who knows? You could, you know, meet your favorite idols. You could get up close and personal with the top two. In fact, you could ask a question to them face to face. Yeah, so drop us an email, singaporeidol@mediacorpstudios.com. In fact, hey, if you got a question for the judges as well, you could drop us an email. They'll be here on the 18th to answer it all. And if you want tickets to that show, you could log on, drop us an email, tell us why you want those tickets, singaporeidol@mediacorpstudios.com. Right now, it's back to Gurmit.
Thank you, Daniel.
Okay, now here's an important announcement. The phone lines are officially closed. I repeat again, the phone lines are officially closed. Singapore, you have made a decision. Find out in a while. It's time for a break. When we return, we'll have a treat all the way from US of A. Special performance by Stacey Orrico. We'll be right back.
Welcomes the delegates and visitors of the IMF and World Bank annual meetings.
Want more with your pull and pop fun? The new triple chicken cheesy bites pizza from Pizza Hut. Succulent chicken meatloaf, tender char-grilled chicken, and irresistible chicken sausages. The new triple chicken cheesy bites. It's a chicken feast you can't resist.
Have you heard of the PCK skate contest?
This is how you do it. You write a script, must be 2 to 4 pages. Send to us. The top 5 will be acted on national TV. By who? By us. Then after that, people at home will SMS and vote. And then the winner get a prize.
Get a chance to work with the cast of PCK. Top prize winner gets $1,888. Send your scripts to pckskit@mediacorp.com.sg. Log on to our website for more details.
You write, we act.
Next on Friday.
I'm a silent anti-hero. Like, I'm not always Superman.
Delve into the mind of controversial underground designer Jazz Low.
The electricity of life is what drives a person to be creative.
Discover a passion for art in its rawest form.
Yep, that's right.
If it's underground,
if it's raw,
if it's art, you'll hear about it first on Front. Monday, 9:30 p.m. on Arts Central.
Crawling babies like rolling over. You need Mommy Boko pants, size M. So stretchy! Just 1, 2, 3, and go!
Easy wear diapers, Mommy Boko pants,
size M.
With record-breaking rating to the US.
I didn't kill that man. I was set up.
And with addictive TV stamped all over it.
What is it about this case the Secret Service is so interested in?
The man killed the Vice President's brother.
The All-New Prison Break, premiering Thursday at 10. See it first on 5.
Welcome back. You're with us on Singapore Idol Results Show. This Saturday, meet your top 2 finalists at the following places. Plaza Singapura, 2 p.m. and Cathay Cineleisure, 4 p.m. But right now, what a treat. All the way from US of A. Give it up, show some love, the one and only Stacey Orrico!
Just about everything that I could go through. When it comes to relationships, don't know what I was missing or why I'm missing. When I told myself that was it, now here I go, I hurt again. Cause of my curiosity, now that it's over, what else could it be? He decides to cheat, I made a promise, never to set, so what didn't I keep it? Cause I did the heartbreak, riding cheats and the fooling around. But I'm not missing you, I'm not going through the motions. Call me, I'm not missing you. You might have me open, but I must be going because I got life is left in your memory. All the times I let you down. I guess love would be nice for someone else.
Michael,
they call
Michael Ty, Michael Ciro.
Really?
Woo!
Yeah, woo! Okay. Welcome to Singapore.
Thank you
for being with us.
Oh, it's so good to be back. It's been a couple years, but
it's been.
It's just as beautiful as ever.
Thank you very much. We are continually renovating this island. Now, what are you busy with right now?
I am just traveling around the world, promoting the new record. Just came in from Japan this morning, actually. Wow. And the last couple months, we've spent a lot of time in Europe, getting ready to launch the record in the US. So yeah, it's been really crazy.
Good stuff. Okay, now, you are the professional, so I'm sure you have some professional advice for our top three finalists here at the Singapore Idol.
Okay, well, I do have a bit of advice. Actually, this was advice that was given to me.
Wow.
At the beginning of my career, and this man said to me, you know, Stacey, do you write your own music? And I said, no, I don't. And he said, well, it doesn't matter, because it's not a gift that you're necessarily born with, like singing is. Writing is something that can be practiced and can be developed as a skill. And so I just started practicing. It started out being something that I didn't do at all, and now I write all my own music, and it makes all the difference in the world. Being able to... just the emotion and personal connection with your music is so vital. And the difference between the beginning of my career when I was singing songs that other people wrote to now singing songs about my own life, the enjoyment level is and the passion in it is totally different. So I would just encourage you guys to like write and write and write and continue to write and
Excellent.
That's my advice.
Thank you very much. Stacey Orico. Very powerful advice. Thank you, Stacey.
Thank you.
We are going for a break. When we come back, we'll have the names of the top two finalists. Stay tuned. Singapore Idol. Welcome back. It's time for the recaps and the results. Here we go. Good luck, guys and lady. Hardy, you sang Got to Get You Into My Life and Desperado. Forgot to Get You Into My Life, Dick said. I guess you deserve all the cheers you are getting because you are in great shape. Your voice is in great shape. That was a great opening act. It was just great. Jacinta said it was effortless and you have a boyish quality which is coming through and which I haven't seen before. For Desperado, Florence said, I like the fact that you were very sincere and you were very anchored and very confident in your delivery. Jacinta said, I really loved it that you got carried away and that is the great thing that has come through in this competition. Ken said, technically it was very good, but I think Dick has a point. Do you know what is the solution? Fall in love. Jasmine, you sang Valentine and Some Hearts. For Valentine, Florence said, I'm sure I speak up for a lot of guys. I'm sure they don't mind being your Valentines. That performance was a little bit diabetic. It was as sweet as you are. Ken said, it was a very sweet rendition, but what was the problem is that the romanticism isn't there. You have to relate to a love song like a love song, not a lullaby. For Some Hearts, Florence said, for me, the problem was that you were singing the song, but you didn't own the song. You didn't grab it by the horns a little bit more like you should have. But I'll give you credit where credit is due. You are the most improved singer on this competition. Jacinta said, it didn't move me because I didn't feel that you had dynamics in the song. Jonathan, You sang In the Air Tonight, and every little thing she does is magic. For In the Air Tonight, Dick said, that was very intense, fantastic interpretation of that song. I think to be the Singapore Idol, you don't necessarily have to be a fantastic singer, but you need to have some kind of special quality, and I think you've got that. Jacinta said, I've been waiting to say this for a long time. I think you're a singer with gravitas, and you are able to put some epic splendor into your vocalizations, and you do that, so it has an epic quality. For every little thing she does is magic, Dick said, you have found the kind of way to sing in a very cool way. You've become the cool guy of the show. I think what you lack now is in the fast numbers, it's just not exciting enough. Florence said, I thought you were a little bit distracted and you went off a little bit on that song. Ken said, when we try and produce an artist, it's not about the power, the range or anything else, but the ability to personalize yourself. I think from Unforgettable to Snow Patrol to what you did tonight, you managed to actually do that and do it very well. So, we have Hadi, we have Jasmine, we have Jonathan. One is going home, and the other two, one step closer to being the next Singapore Idol. Who's it gonna be? I'll tell you after the break. Welcome back on Singapore Idol Results Show. Welcome back. As you can see, I have three idols on stage. We have Hadi, Jasmine, Jonathan. Who stays and who goes? I have in my right hand the results. Singapore has decided that you are leaving us tonight. I'm sorry your idol journey has ended tonight, but thank you so much for being part of this journey. Thank you, Jasmine. And that means Hadi and Jonathan, you are the top two finalists. Congratulations. Two of you. Hadi, John, take a seat, please. Jasmine, here is a video of your idol journey.
You have a nice voice, but why are you wearing something that looks like a potato sack?
You blossom into a white rose that smells as sweet as a night.
The idol journey has been really special to me. I've enjoyed every moment of it. Being there, cheering at Cathay City. My most memorable moment would be the training at the boot camp. I really had so much fun working hard together with my friends towards a common goal.
Jasmine, you are going to the next round.
I've learned that it's not impossible to realize your dreams as long as you work hard and you work smart. And most importantly, I get to see the different aspects of life. I'm coming back
home. Jasmine, we'll talk to you in a little while, okay? Okay. Ken, your comments on Singapore's decision tonight.
Well, you know, from the early stages of the Spectaculars, Dick, Florence, maybe Ja and myself, we sort of identified both of them to be the best candidates for the finals.
Okay.
This is basically based upon, you know, the qualities that they have.
Right.
And it's already ready.
Right.
But what's important is, Jasmine, you must go on living your dreams, right? It's just not time for you yet. Okay?
Ken, how should Singapore vote in the grand finals? Now that we know Hadi and John are going to be in the grand finals, how, to be fair and square to everybody who's been in this journey, how can Singapore vote in
you
the
know,
finals?
Hang on. To be very fair to the two contestants there, you know, we should start from a fresh perspective.
Okay.
Know, gauge their performance during that night and make the right choice.
Okay. Well said. Thank you very much, Ken. So, Singapore, you've heard it. When it comes to the grand finals, everything they've done in the past is all erased.
was what happened there at the Singapore Indoor Stadium, and that's where we will base our votes on. Okay. How do you feel?
I'm feeling all right, you know, okay. A little bit, like, sad because I have to leave them, you know, I have to leave the competition. Everything is gonna, like, you know, gonna be a little bit weird. But yeah. I'm really, like, feeling very satisfied to have come this far. And I wouldn't have done this without the help of my family, my friends, my fans. Thank you, judges.
And the nice thing is we went all the way to top three. Does that feel good?
It feels good.
It feels very good.
And, guys, all the way, okay? Yeah.
Okay. That's it for the show. Let's thank the judges. Thank you, Digley, Florence,
yeah.
Jacinta, Ken Lim.
All right, folks, so next Wednesday, we have two very special preview episodes before the grand finals. We'll get up close and personal with the top two finalists before they battle it out for the Singapore Idol crown at the Indoor Stadium, September 24th as well as 25th. So, who's it going to be? If you've got any questions for them, remember you could, well, drop us an email, singaporeidol@mediacorpstudios.com. If they've got any questions for the judges, they'll have, you'll be answering your questions as well, all right? So,
that's it, right? Okay, but then with us, next Wednesday, 8 p.m. is top two up close. That's going to be exciting. And it's going to come out on Thursday, the journey at 8 p.m. Thank you for watching us on Singapore Idol on 5. We want to help you. We want to say goodnight, and we'll ask Jasmine to say goodnight to us. Go ahead, Jasmine.